let's be real with our audience here. You guys say this every year. 6-10, 8-8, 8-8 over the last 3 years. Don't you feel y'all underachieved?
Not at all. Not at all. We're getting better. We're getting better. We're getting better.
You're off for 2 8-8 seasons, DeMarco?
We're getting better. You know, we're getting better. That's all I can say about that. We're getting better.
But how did you not underachieve?
We're getting better.
Clearly, I'm not being direct enough. Is it a playoff appearance, a Super Bowl, the NFC East crown? What's the goal?
Our goal is to, you know, get better during training camp, you know, build our foundation, continue to build our foundation, and we'll see what happens then.
That's it?
To create no expectations, Stephen A.
That was about a year ago today. 8-8. Our next guest, obviously, star running back for the Dallas Cowboys, America's team, but I guess it's not America's team anymore, according to some people.
It is America's team.
Oh, don't you start.
Kerry Champion.
Go.
Excuse me for a second.
Uh-oh, he's about to let you have it. Let me move
on. What's going on, DeMarco? How you doing, bro?
I'm good.
Let me say this before I say anything else. 1,121 yards. You played 14 games. So first of all, proud of you because you played well. Secondly, I'm happy for you because you weren't really injured. You see what I'm saying? So I think that was a big, big deal considering what happened to you prior to last season. So my beef's not with you, DeMarco.
So,
mind your business, Skip. Mind your business. Don't try to mess with him. I got this. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying to you, DeMarco, is this. My issue is not with you, but my issue is with what you say. You said to us, you're getting better. For the third consecutive year, the Dallas Cowboy, the walking piece of mediocrity, the accident waiting to happen that the Cowboys are, proved themselves to be just that again with an 8-8 record. Explain yourself and your team.
It was a bad year for us. Obviously, you know, it's nothing that we didn't. I think we worked hard last year. We had a good off season and things of that nature, but definitely didn't live up to our expectations. And I'm sure our fans and the tradition that we know, the legacy that comes along with wearing that star. But you know, it happened. You know, we got to move on. We got to, you know, learn from that, and hopefully this year we'll get better.
You know,
you're so serious.
You know, I mean, DeMarco, look, that sounds good. You're fantastic, man. I mean, really, I mean, when you go,
that was a good answer.
When your career is over, you should run for office. I mean, it's a great answer. But again, 3 consecutive 8-8 seasons. When y'all go in the locker room, is there ever a time that y'all go in the locker room and y'all go like this? Damn, we running out of explanations. I mean, have y'all ever said that?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a difficult process to go out like that. And, you know, we've given ourselves a chance to, you know, at the last game of the year and give ourselves a chance to, you know, play and make it to the playoffs. And we came up short. So, I mean, a lot of teams don't have that type of, you know, expectation going into the last game. And we've given ourselves a chance. And so hopefully, you know, this year it doesn't happen that way. But, hey, you never know. I mean, whatever. You got to win the games. You got to win the big games. And, you know, we didn't end up doing that.
DeMarco, I must say, I know that you couldn't do this because you were coming off an injury and you had to, you know, sort of prove yourself again that you're going to stay healthy and what have you. But if it were not for that, DeMarco, I kind of wonder whether or not you shouldn't ask to be traded. Because there have been several occasions last year when I did say I thought you should have gotten the ball more. I thought one of their problems is that they weren't giving you the ball more because they wanted to give the ball to Tony Romo and have him and Jason Witten come to the rescue. And for the 4th consecutive year, they failed to do so because it's been that long since America's team hasn't even been to the playoffs. Have you ever going to Jerry Jones, Stephen Jones, Jason Garrett, and just said, you know, I kind of need the ball more. Have you ever done that?
You know, I've had some talks with Garrett, and we know we need to run the ball, and we also have great playmakers and Dez and Witten and Romo. So we you know, there's different types of things that we do considering a game, and at times we want to run the ball, there's times we want to throw it, and you know, at the same time, you know, our coaches know what's best for the team, and us and players, we believe in the decisions that they make, and we got to, you know, make those guys right.
So y'all really believe in the decisions they make.
I think it was up to us. You know, if we would have made those plays, those key plays, we wouldn't be sitting up here talking about that.
DeMarco,
so it's up to the players.
I got your back. Yeah. I want you to ask him a question for me, okay? Who's better off right now, the Cowboys or the Lakers?
The Cowboys or the Lakers,
what
my man?
What kind of question is that?
It's a great question.
A ridiculous question.
You know what? The Lakers.
No, that's wrong.
You want me to tell you
that's wrong? Wrong.
No, no, no.
Why is that wrong?
Do I get an answer? Do I get an opportunity to answer your question? To answer your question.
I like
Let me tell you something right now. At least the Lakers got Kobe coming back. Y'all got Romo. Excuse me. Do you have Romo coming back? And Mr. Bad back. He could be just because you had Cameron Indoor Stadium shooting jumpers. Okay, what? Don't mean you can play football.
Wait a second. How about this ruptured Achilles and broken knee?
Please. That's still better than Romo.
Yeah. Relax.
Go ahead, DeMarco. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Go ahead, Skip. Y'all talk to each other.
Because the Cowboys are better off than the Lakers, so you have to keep that in perspective.
And I want to be clear. I love Dez. I love you. You understand? Y'all can play. And I ain't knocking individuals. It's just that collectively, I think it's an absolute joke that the Cowboys are America's team. That needs to be said. Not your fault, though. But go ahead.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Okay, help him out here. Tell him that the Dallas Cowboys are about to have maybe the most explosive offense in the league.
Maybe. Sorry. Wait a second.
Yeah, you laugh, and you're going to be crying on this one. Help me out here. Is your offensive line not becoming one of the maybe the best in the league? Does it have potential to be the best in the league?
I definitely think they do. You know, those guys are led by Coach Callahan. They work extremely hard. The hardest working group on the team and maybe in the NFL. And I'm proud to run behind those guys. I love those guys, and I wouldn't trade it from anybody else. And we got Linehan coming in, and, you know, he's definitely, sparked
new
us
coordinator.
A little bit as well. Yep. Definitely, we have a lot of playmakers, we're excited.
Does Dez Bryant still play on your team?
He does.
I think 88 is still there.
Is he not a top five wide receiver? At least top five, right?
Wait a minute. Don't you come on this show and act like I've not Dez. I've always raved about
Thank
Dez.
Thank you.
You are the one that got on Dez. Dez gets knocked out of bounds, and Skip talking about you got to find a way to keep your foot in. You know, Skip getting on Dez Bryant. I'm the one that supports Dez Bryant on this show.
Okay,
not
so what's
you.
The problem?
So here's my problem. Jason Garrett and Scott Linehan and Steven and Jerry Jones, the Jones twins, as far as I'm concerned, are still going to call for Tony Romo to come to the rescue. It doesn't matter what you do. You do understand, DeMarco, don't you?
Uh-huh.
It don't matter what you do. You can run for 1,500 yards. When it count most, they ain't going to give you the ball. They're going to give it to Romo. You do know that, right? You do know that, right? You know that, right?
Look, I'm interested here. I'm teaming up with Old Spice. I'm trying to...
I got you.
Spice is best. You know, deodorant, you know, the body wash, the shampoo, you know, so, you know, if you want to stay fresh from head to toe, you got to use Old Spice.
Well, first of all, I use Old Spice, so I appreciate it. I'm going to work on that. But I got to ask you this question. That ain't the only reason you here. You kind of love being here with us. Don't act like you don't. You just don't want to call out your teammate, which you shouldn't.
I enjoy this segment.
You know. You know what? I tell you what. I tell you what. Can you do me a favor?
What's
can
that?
You hook me up with an interview with Jerry Jones? So I could sit in front, because I could come down to Big D and sit in front of Jerry Jones and ask him to his face, what justifies the Cowboys being called America's team? Could you set that up?
I can tell you what the answer would be.
Because they dominate the TV ratings year after year after year. All the biggest TV ratings belong to the Dallas Cowboys. That qualifies you as America's most watched team.
Okay.
I tell you what, I think y'all will go to the playoffs if they give you the ball more. So I'm wrong for saying that now? Make you uncomfortable with that?
No, not at all.
Thank you very much.
I feel like, you know, we've done some good things, and we're going to continue to do those things. And whether it's running, passing, you know, I think we have a good chance to, you know, do some great things and special things this year.
I would love you as my teammate.
Do you have the makings of the most explosive offense in the National Football League?
I think we definitely have some work to do. You know, we're still learning new.
I definitely believe that with all my heart. He said it.
Yeah, look, y'all. You know what? All right. Because, see, y'all looking at me like I'm cruel now.
You are cruel.
What you should be bringing up right now
is how bad the defense is. Because it's a problem.
Listen, Sean Lee is gone.
It's a problem.
I know that, but the defense was awful with him there. Okay? And I like Sean Lee. But the defense was awful with him there. So it doesn't make a difference. The point that I'm trying to make to you. Listen, what have I said to you? I've laid the picture out for you. The Dallas Cowboys could be putting up points, as they showed you against Denver. They could score 48 points one game. They could score 10 the next. It don't matter. They find a way to get in their own way. There was a couple of games when all they had to do was hand this man the ball and it would have been fine, and they can't do it.
Well, all they had to do one game against Peyton Manning was for Tony Romo
talk about
not to throw
Spice,
it to the other team.
Talk about Old Spice, man. What else you want to say about Old Spice, man?
I'll be at the Santa Monica Pier. I'll be at the Santa Monica Pier later on, handing out some, you know, some ice cream and handing out some
really
Old Spice
nice.
Combinations.
Let's
so make sure you guys come.
Okay, so
sure
obviously, DeMarco Murray here on behalf of Old Spice. Thank you for being such a trooper. You handle yourself like a trooper.
And I use Old Spice. I encourage
that.
Everybody to use Old Spice.
DeMarco Murray is a gentleman, and we appreciate
it. He is.
Thank you so much.
Lucky to have him. Boy, they
are.
He don't say a bad word about anybody.
He's a great guy.
He really does.
Let's talk about another great guy.
Good for you.
Never been on the show.
I'm not that
first time here. Our next guest helped shut down the Broncos offense. You guys may know him. You guys